Welcome back. In the previous class, we have observed that Fourier series representation allows us to apply the phasor method in analyzing circuits when the source function is a non-sinusoidal periodic function. We use phasor technique to determine the response of each harmonic in the series and transform the responses to the time domain and add them up. In this way, Fourier series has several advantages in order to analyze the circuit. In today's lecture, I am going to talk about the more compact way to represent the Fourier series, and that one is nothing but the exponential form, because we have seen that using Euler identity, I can express sine and cosine function in terms of exponential, keeping that identity in mind, I am going to represent or I am going to replace cos and sine of the Fourier series by the complex exponential function, and after that whatever series that comes into picture, that is called exponential Fourier series. So let us start the lecture. So I am going to use following Euler identity. So I am going to use the Euler's identity. So using this identity, I can represent cos n omega 0 t equal to 1 by 2 exponential j n omega 0 t plus e power minus j n omega 0 t. And similarly, I can also represent sine n omega 0 t by 1 by 2 j and after that e power j n omega 0 t minus e power minus j n omega 0 into t, where j is nothing but square root of minus 1. And after that, using this identity, if I substitute to the trigonometric Fourier series, then I will get the following. So I am going to represent that by Ft. So I am not going to replace the DC component, so that is a 0, and after that I have 1 by 2, and here summation n equal to 1 to infinity, and I have a n and minus j b n, and after that I have e power j n omega 0 t. So I am going to collect exponential term which is increasing with respect to time, and second one is a n plus j b n and this is e minus j n omega 0 t, like this. And now I can see that here the some another definition I am going to use. So now let us see that if we define a new coefficient and that coefficient is Cn, so that I am going to assume that C0 is nothing but exactly equal to the A0, and after that I have coefficient Cn, that is An minus JBn by 2. So this is our definition. So I can also write the coefficient C, and this is complex conjugate, or I can also write this by replacing n by minus n. So this is An plus JBn by 2. So in this way I can now again represent above series in more compact form. So this is just a definition, and after that I can write like this. Then FT becomes, that is FT equal to C0 plus, now I have summation n equal to n to infinity Cn e power j n omega 0 t, and plus C minus n e power minus j n omega 0 t, like this. And in more compact way I can write f t like this, that is nothing but summation n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity and C n e power j n omega 0 into t. You can see that this particular form is exactly equal to this form. So basically I can either, this implies this or this implies this. So actually my summation is now from minus infinity to plus infinity, so that will generate minus infinity up to 0, that will generate this term up to n up to minus 1. Exactly at 0 I have C0, and n equal to 1 to infinity, that is going to generate this particular term Cn e power j n omega 0 t. So this is the very very compact representation of the Fourier series, and this representation I am going to write now. I am going to comment on this representation. So this is the complex or exponential Fourier series representation of periodic function f t, because I have inherent assumption that ft is the periodic function. So same kind of assumption I am going to carry in case of exponential Fourier series also. So this is called exponential Fourier series. So one can easily see that this is more compact than sine and cosine. So and one can calculate cn from the an and bn, because we have seen that how to calculate cn, how to calculate cn minus if I know an or bn. One can also obtain cn directly from the ft. So let us write this. So even if I do not know an or bn, but I can calculate the cn directly from the ft. So one can also calculate coefficients, that is called cn, directly from ft. It means that without knowing an and bn also I can proceed. So that is nothing but 1 by t 0 to t ft e power minus j n omega 0 t into dt. I am not going to talk the proof why this is actually equal to cn. Just you can remember that in this way I am able to calculate the e power j n omega 0 t. Proof is also not so difficult. Just you can multiply both sides by ft e power j n omega 0 t, and you know that behavior of average behavior of function in one time period is given like this. So you can just take integration from the one period. In this way I can recover the cn, and where omega 0 we know, that is 2 pi by t. So it is better to write where omega 0, so omega 0 is nothing but 2 pi by t, and where t is the period of the periodic function, because I have already told that our assumption is that ft is the periodic function. Now what we have observed, that in the complex representation I have magnitude and phase of cn versus n0, and this is called complex amplitude spectrum and complex phase spectrum of the ft respectively. So basically let us write this thing, because most of time whenever we are driving the exponential Fourier series, at that time we have to plot the magnitude and phase spectrum. So remark is like this: the plots of the magnitude and phase, because you can easily see that cn is a complex quantity, so it has both magnitude and phase versus n omega 0 are called the complex amplitude spectrum and complex phase spectrum. And several places, particularly in communication system, we are using these kind of concept. So this respective. So now, from the Fourier series, also I can calculate the coefficient. This is the direct way of the calculation of the coefficient. In another way, I can also able to do, that is like this, a n and phi n, that is nothing but a n minus j b n, and this equal to c n. So now here you can see that in this I have assumed that a n minus j b n by 2 equal to c n. So due to that reason, I have to do certain modification here, and that is equal to 2cn. And now cn is complex number, so I can write cn like cn and theta n, and where this is nothing but an square plus bn square by 2 tan inverse, and this is basically the angle, so minus tan inverse bn by an. So in this way I can able to calculate the amplitude spectrum as well as the phase spectrum. And if trigonometric Fourier series is given, then also I can plot the complex spectrum. That is the relation between the trigonometric Fourier series and complex Fourier series. Now, since I am able to represent the FT in terms of complex Fourier series, so I can also able to define the RMS value of any signal, any periodic signal, particularly in terms of the complex Fourier series. So let us write that in terms of the Fourier complex coefficients, that is Cn, the RMS value of a periodic signal. And in previous class we have already seen that how to calculate RMS value in terms of the Fourier series. Can we found as, so now I have generalization of the RMS value, so I can able to calculate RMS value for any periodic function with help of this, and that is nothing but f RMS square, that is equal to 1 by t integral 0 to t f square t into dt. So basically this is 1 by t 0 to t f t, and I am going to represent the 1 f t, and you are able to understand why basically we are doing this. In this way we will get certain kind of advantage. Due to that reason I am going to represent, I am keeping 1 f t and another f t I am writing in terms of complex Fourier series, that is j n omega 0 t, and after that I have dt. Now one can also able to exchange this particular summation and this integration, then result again remains the same. Due to that reason I have like this, and cn, and cn is constant, so I can take it out from the integral, and after that I will write like this, 1 by t 0 to t f t e power j n omega 0 t into dt. Now let us try to see this term, this particular term. So this particular term is nothing but cn and complex conjugate, or also you can write c minus n. So due to that reason I can further write this like n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity, and I have cn, and cn I have complex conjugate. So basically now I am getting this square. So basically from here I can now able to calculate the RMS value. So basically f RMS can be defined like this, that is a square root of the summation of the all coefficient of the complex Fourier series like this. So this can be further written like this also, that f RMS square is C0 square plus 2 summation 1 equal 1 to infinity and cn square. In this form also I can calculate the RMS value. So in this way, if I represent the any periodic signal in terms of complex Fourier series, so I am able to perform again all kind of power analysis, because using RMS somehow I am calculating the effective value. Effective value or average value of power absorbed by some resistor. So if FT is the voltage across any resistor, so then average power absorbed by resistor I can directly write that F RMS square by R. If FT is the current through R, then power I can write F RMS square into R. So in this way I can able to take advantage of the exponential series representation. Now let us come to one example, and after that I am going to close the today's lecture. Again, in order to save my time, I have already solved the example. Same kind of policy now I am using in order to minimize the time of the lecture. So now let us consider this periodic pulse, and goal is to obtain amplitude and phase spectra. So first step is that to identify the periodicity of the signal, and it is not hard to see that period t is 10, because here signal is going to start from here, and after that I have here, and this kind of representation occurs in left hand as well as right hand of this particular pulse. So we are telling that period of this pulse is t equal to 10. So once I know the period, then I am able to get the fundamental angular frequency omega, that is 2 pi by t, that is pi by 6. So in this way I have calculated up to this. Now I know how to calculate the coefficient of complex Fourier series. So that is Cn 1 by t 0 to t ft e power j n omega 0 t with negative sign into dt. Now here you can see that either I can calculate this integral, or I can write integral from minus t by 2 to t by 2. Again, value remains the same, because here why I am writing in this form, because if you see this signal, so this signal from here to here I have some numerical value, and after that I have here to here I have some numerical value, and zero almost everywhere. So either you can calculate integral from here to here, or you can calculate from here to here, so that doesn't matter. Due to that reason I have used this kind of property, and finally you can see that I am going to integrate from minus t by 2 to t by 2, and within this interval if you see t is 10, so I have to integrate from minus 5 to plus 5, so only I have finite quantity, or from minus 1 to 1, otherwise signal is everywhere 0. Due to that reason this definite integral limit is from minus 1 to 1, and once I will integrate this, then I am able to generate this. So I think that up to here you do not have any confusion, and after that just you can substitute it. And finally, if I will use here Euler identity, so I am going to use here Euler identity. So using Euler identity and doing this kind of manipulation, so I am using Euler identity from here to here, so basically this is exactly equal to this sin n omega 0, and n omega 0 is coming from here, then I will get this value, and after substituting omega 0, that is pi by 5, I will get Cn, that can be represented like this. So this is the coefficient of the complex Fourier series, and once I will get this, then I can write the complex Fourier series, and that is now looks like this. So this is just from the definition. Now let us try to see this function, because here I will get this particular function, so that is somehow I can represent sin x by x. So this function has some special name, that is sin c function, and there are several property of this function. And why we are exploring property? Because I have to plot the phase spectrum as well as the amplitude spectrum. So if I know the property of this, then it is pretty easy to visualize the spectrum. And this function, sin c function, is also called sampling function in communication theory, because there are several applications of this particular function. Because if you have certain idea of communication, then somehow we are transmitting data, we are receiving data, so somehow we have to modulate our signals. At that time, this function has several role. I am not going to discuss that. Just I am going to see the property of sin c function. So this function at 0 equal to 1, and this is very easy to see by using L'Hopital rule. So people are also telling this as a L'Hopital, but correct pronunciation is L'Hopital. So sin x by x, x tending towards 0, that is equal to 1, one can see from the L'Hopital. After that, another property of this, at integral multiple of pi, the value of sin c function is 0. So that is the property of this particular function. You can easily able to see why I am telling this. And sin c function is actually symmetry. So it has even symmetry. So due to that region, means whatever things in left hand, same kind of things one can visualize in right hand of the y-axis due to this symmetry. So now let us talk about the plot. So in order to do plot, I am going to collect the magnitude of Cn. So magnitude of Cn is nothing but this, and if you see theta n, that equal to 0 and 180. So we know that if I have complex number, then how to get angle and magnitude. So I am not going to discuss again about this. Now let us just come to the plot. So in order to do plot, I have to vary n from minus 10 to 10, and where n is the normalized frequency, omega is any general frequency by omega 0, because I know that n omega 0 equal to omega. So if you plot this, then this kind of shape comes into picture. And if you see the profile, then that is if the profile of sin c function. Similarly, you are able to see the phase spectrum. So phase is 0 between these two, minus 5 to 5. So nowhere any quantity is going to appear. So this is somehow 0. And suddenly on both sides, I have 180 degree phase comes into picture. And so this is the phase spectrum. So if you see both the amplitude spectrum as well as phase spectrum, they are called the line spectrum, because you can see that only at the discrete value of frequency, the value of Cn and theta n are going to occur. Due to that region, this spectrum is also called the line spectrum. And spacing between any two lines is nothing but the omega 0. And I have already told you that if you join all the points, then you are able to get the envelope of amplitude function that is exactly like sin c. So with this numerical example, I am going to close the today's class. So what we have observed, that in this whole Fourier series analysis, I have two different representation. One representation is trigonometric representation, another is exponential representation. And any periodic signal can be represented in both representation, means trigonometric representation as well as the exponential representation. And once I will get this kind of representation, then using the help of phasor as well as the superposition, I am able to calculate the response of the periodic function to any linear circuit by applying the superposition theorem. So due to that reason, we have spent considerable amount of time in this particular topic. And another advantage is that I can also able to do the power analysis. So with these remark, I am going to end this part of the lecture. Thank you very much.